can I suggest something? We'll do the pictures afterwards. I'll stand up and we'll do all the pictures you guys want.
We need also some pictures of you talking, you know, it's normal to have someone when it's
right.
On
press
conference.
Right, and make sure you don't catch me with my mouth open because it's really all right, so what I mean by that is the songs I've been traveling all along through the last 6 or 8 months because, I shouldn't say 16, 18 months, yes, so a year and a half ago I started a tour in Eastern countries, and I've been singing all my songs, Je t'aime, Adagio, La différence, J'y crois encore, all of these songs in French that have been really important in my life, and that I've gathered a lot of audience. So that's mainly what I'm going to do. I'm also going to sing a few songs from women that I respect. It's my second time.
Second time.
Yes, I was here out of pleasure just because I wanted to discover. Yes, I wanted to discover the city, so I came here 3 days. And went through everything you can do and see, and I just adored the city. And I remember being on St. Paul's Bridge and thinking it would be so cool to be able to be here.
And this time you have some schedule for some
No, time. Not really, because we only, like, we do it one city every day. Now, throughout my career, I think you asked if there was one collaboration that made a big impression on me. Many made a big impression on me. But there is definitely one moment in my life that I recall. It was to sing in New York at the Madison Square Garden for a concert that was called Miracle on 42nd Street. And there was Michael Jackson that evening. And all of us were singing. There was Beyonce, Michael, many people. And I was part of the party of singers. And I remember when I finished Adagio, he turned to me and he held me and he said something really sweet, and actually more than that. And I just can't remember how softly he spoke, how, like, almost, he almost had the voice of a child. And it really particularly moved me, I have to say. And also, who is not a fan of Michael Jackson and the legacy that he is, and the vision he had and what he represents. So now that he's gone, I cherish that moment and remember how precious it was to sing on the same stage and to share one song with all these fantastic artists. John Williams, who scores every movie of Steven Spielberg, called me one night to ask me if I knew how to read music. And thank God I could say yes, because my mother forced me all my life to go to the conservatory. She was there. So I flew to Boston and he asked me so if I could read, so he laid out a long sheet of charts. It was like 36 pages. And he asked me to sing the song as reading. And that's how he auditioned me with the Boston Symphonic Orchestra. And so when I was finished walking through the whole stage through the charts, he said, "Oh, you can read." And then I told you I could say I need to see. So that's how he hired me for that gig, because he thought it was important that someone who sings can also read music. It's a little anecdote that I find so touching. And then I had the chance to work with him on the score, on the produced version, as well as on the sound music, film music version. And it was quite an experience to work with John Williams and Steven Spielberg, who witnessed the movie with the song at the end and just loved it and decided to keep it. So to me, it's always a mystery how it happens. I cannot tell you why. For instance, Je suis malade, you know that song from Serge Lama that I sing. I could never make a translation. I've translated a few songs of mine, but that one, it's French. It's Je suis malade, that's it. You can't use that. Whether Adagio could be Italian or English, but could never be French, even though I have a French career, and it would have been important to have it in French. Impossible. So to me, it's a bit of a mystery. The chemistry, the magic that happens between a language and the music that it serves, it's a bit of a mystery. I don't really know how I do it, but I know it's right. You know, when I start writing, this is how it should be, for me, I mean.
Thank you.
This way, it's no problem. That's fine. It's just, sorry. Would you hold on? It's okay. I have a problem with it, and I can lose myself. It's the only reason I'm asking. So don't you go to the
Non ha problemi a sfruttare, non ha problemi a sfruttare.